individual fingertips. Notice there is an orientation value on there that is actually telling me how my fingertip is turned. Why is that cool? Because if you, sir, are touching the display from that side, would it make any sense for me to display the data this way? Not at all. I want it flipped to you. So you want to be able to understand that. Now look, we track massively all the contact points. So we know the difference between a fingertip and a blob, all right? So there is saying, there's a big flipping blob. I can see fingertips in here. Now why is that important? Well, in some situations, you may actually want to recognize an object being placed on it. So imagine you take a product and just set it on the screen. The computer just sees it and goes, oh, well, groovy, I get that. I know how to do something with that. Same thing, we also differentiate. There's a tag on here. If you look on the back of this card, there's a domino tag. What's happening is the tracker has realized that's an object, and here's the actual domino tag value. So imagine a scenario where you're a retailer, you issue out coupons and such, and you just print that domino tag on there. They come in here and they drop it. We can uniquely identify those, so you can, everybody can have a different one, or they can have their own. So different offers based on different people interacting with the environment. Cool? You guys can touch it. Don't be afraid, man.
This is how I line up my screen here in the game. We'll see. I don't know how effective I'm going to be in not just seeing how the bar here.
Now, I've shown you all the internals, but the real beauty is more in the applications themselves. So when you start looking at, let's go pick on. Let's see here. We were playing the tiles game earlier. So now the idea is to hold your hand down, and now we can play. Now if you go put your finger down, hold it down longer. It's going. You got to tell it for sure you want to play. Now, did you see what just happened? Your pie slice was oriented to you. It wasn't oriented to me. So now the idea is you're supposed to match four colors in a row. So there we go. Now I shoot an energy beam at you and I try to knock out all your parts.
It only works with application.
So this is using the Windows 7. This is Windows 7 under the hood. So it's using the Windows 7 touch quantity. The challenge is that still they'd be a little challenged by the touch points. They'd be a little small. Now, yeah, the little buttons, this is actually an interesting add-on from what we used to do. It used to be you just touched on the button and it changed. What we found was as people were playing games, we'd accidentally shut off the game. So what you want to do is slide it up, and now we're back to the menu bar that actually allows us to choose what we want to play. RBC application is demonstrating the use of these data points on the bottom of the card. So we can go ahead and, because it recognized that domino tag, it's automatically, you come into the bank, you slap your card down from the mail, and look at there, I've just won a $100 Visa card. Is that cool or what, right? So we'll close that, but then we can go into the kids' corner. There we go, and they get to play puzzles. Actually, what's interesting is some of the banks in the EU have discovered that writing applications for kids is a better model than writing them for adults. So what they'll do is they'll write financial applications that focus on kids, play, that kind of stuff, and they'll have things in there about auto loans or home loans. And what happens, they find, is mom, come over here. You gotta see this, this is too cool. And mom gets sucked in, and it's really kind of an ingenious way to get mom and dad to come over and interact with the device, because they're not afraid of it, all right? So here is a nice interactive way. Yeah, I'm gonna flip it since you're over there. There we go. So we can go ahead and look at everyday banking. Oh, there we go. We can explore different options. Now you could argue that, wow, that's a big bloody kiosk flipped on its side, and actually it is. But the key is again, back to the point that this isn't a touch screen. This is computer vision. So this computer sees you. So now, literally, you can have physical items around the display that you put on the display and it reacts to that. Just as when I put this card down, it reacted to what was on the back of this card. So the idea is that if it's a traditional touch display, I don't know how to deal with orientations other than the one that I'm on. So in other words, X is one way, Y is another way. It doesn't understand that people are all the way around the device. There we go.